This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there, welcome to episode 7, Solving Quadratic Equations. In this episode, we'll learn how to solve an equation that contains x squared terms. Let's get started. So the question I've given you today is 2x squared minus 10x plus 8 equals 2 times the quantity x minus 4. The first thing we want to do is to try to distribute anything we can to make it easier to move the terms around. We do have an expression here that we can distribute, right there, and we can say 2 times x is 2x, and 2 times negative 4 is negative 8. And the rest of the expression will stay the same for now. Now for step 2. If we want to solve a quadratic equation, we need to have all of the terms on the same side. So let's move this 2x, and let's move this negative 8. We'll do this in red. Well, since we have a positive 2x, let's subtract it from both sides, and we'll write it underneath the other x term that we have already. Also, we have negative 8, so let's add 8 to both sides. And let's cancel out whatever we can here. Well, 2x and negative 2x cancels out. Negative 8 and positive 8 cancels out. So we have nothing left on the right side. We just have 0. Now we have 2x squared. We didn't do any operations to it, so it is still 2x squared. Negative 10x and negative 2x makes negative 12x. Positive 8 and positive 8 makes positive 16. Now that we have everything on the same side, let's try to simplify our math a bit here in step 3. If we have a common factor for all three terms, let's divide everything by that common factor to make our numbers lower, so our calculations will be simpler. Well, you might notice they are all even numbers. And if you have all even numbers, you can divide every term by 2 to make your numbers a little simpler to work with. The 2's here in front of the x squared cancel out, giving us just x squared. Negative 12 divided by 2 gives us negative 6, still with the x. Positive 16 divided by 2 gives us positive 8, and it all still equals 0. Now that we have all the terms moved to the left and written in simplest form possible, now we need to solve the equation. And in order to solve the equation, we are going to have to factor it. So like what I did in the previous episode, I labeled the x squared term as a, the x term as b, and the term with no x as c. What we need to do to factor this is find two numbers that multiply to c and add to b. So we are going to have to make two numbers that multiply to 8 but add to negative 6. Now just for a little hint here, let's look to c. And it says if c is positive, then the numbers we need are the same sign. Well, c is positive. So let's try to find two numbers with the same sign that add to negative 6. Well, it's a pretty good bet that the numbers we need are going to be negative. So let's keep our eyes open for two negative numbers. Because if they were positive, there's no way they could add to negative 6. Well, what are two negative numbers that multiply to 8? We could try negative 1 and negative 8. Let's see if that adds to negative 6. Negative 1 minus 8 is negative 9. So that's not going to work. Let's try two more numbers. Well, what about negative 2 and negative 4? Well, negative 2 times negative 4 also multiplies to 8, and negative 2 minus 4 gives us negative 6. That's a match with the number it needs to add to. So these are the correct numbers. negative 2, and negative 4. We'll write them again down here. Now, in order to factor it, we're going to break this expression up above into two parentheses. Both of those parentheses will contain an x. To the first parentheses, we'll bring down the negative 2, so the first parentheses reads x minus 2. To the other one, we'll bring down negative 4, so it reads x minus 4. And remember that it equals 0, because it equals 0 up here. Now that brings us to step 5. Now that we have our two parentheses equaling 0, we're going to break this equation apart into two small equations. X minus 2 equals 0, and x minus 4 equals 0. Well, let's solve the first one. All we need to do is move the negative 2 to the other side, so we'll add 2 to both sides. These 2's cancel out, and our solution is x equals 2. Let's do it again to the other equation. We'll add 4 to both sides this time. The negative 4 and positive 4 cancel out, and so our other solution is x equals 4. And this is what should happen in a quadratic equation. You should end up with two numbers that are both solutions. I know this was kind of involved, so let's briefly recap what we've done. We've started with a very messy looking equation, and what we needed to do in order to make sense of it is to move everything over to the left and simplify it as much as possible. And now it doesn't look so bad. Then we factor the expression to get two parentheses, and we solve each piece of the equation separately to get x equals 4 and x equals 2. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you again next episode.